Love, peace, light, and darkness. So family, welcome. If you are one of my A1 day ones, I love y'all. I miss y'all. I want to tap into this full moon in Gemini energy. I want to see what's good, what's tea, what the ancestors have to say about this energy. I do have a download for us regarding full moon in Gemini, or just regarding the overall energy in general, right? I told myself we may or we may not pull cards. So I'm just going to shuffle up a little bit and see. How are you guys in here? Literally says zero people, y'all. But shout out to you, K Goddess. What's up, Debbie? I missed you too, y'all. It literally says zero people in here. Hey, Charlista. Gail. Mahogany. I miss y'all so much. Fire's Art. You guys, it literally says zero people in here. How are you guys? How are y'all in here? Okay, so I felt the love from Destiny's reading. Y'all definitely came through on my channel and kind of guilt tripped me into coming on and at least saying, hey, I'm alive, okay? So shout out to Destiny for always pulling me out of hermit mode in the most gentlest ways possible, because she knows when I overstay my welcome in them shadows. Okay, there it is. Y'all, it just jumped from 0 to 22 like that. I miss y'all too. I love y'all too. How y'all been? How y'all been doing? What's the energies been like for you guys lately? Before I go into a rant. You like my sweater? I got this from Shein, y'all. I'm just saying, if you know, you know. If you know, right? The energies have been tumultuous. A Debbie, shout out to your adjective. That was a one-hitter quitter, right? Anybody else got a little adjective that just a one-liner? What the energy's been like for y'all? Chaotic. I felt that, K Goddess. I felt that. Little chaos in the air. I'm glad to be back, K Swin. I miss y'all. Terry! Grand Rising's Empress. Love to see your face. Okay, talking with Tarot said detachment, intuition popping, and just learning silence. I love that. Just crazy, Cynthia. I felt that. Yes, Destiny did get my ass back on YouTube. As she should. As she should. Inside of me. Cindy! Shout out to you, Cindy. I miss y'all faces so much. Like, you can't tell me this not a real family. Like, what you mean? This our little family. You've been in hermit mode. Well, as y'all can see, clearly I've been there with you, Michelle. Okay, y'all. So I think we got enough people in here for me to start talking my shit, right? Johari, I miss you, my love. All right, y'all. So I'm glad y'all kind of confirmed that the energy's just kind of been sporadic and all over the place, right? So the download that I had to share with you guys is what I processed that I was somewhat going through, I guess. And in the spiritual community, we use the butterfly as an analogy in regards to a lot of the processes of evolution, right? And the butterfly is just so cute. It's so pretty. And it's just, I don't know. It gives like these false illusions that the transformation is once again just fairy tales and unicorns. Anywho, if your transformation's been like that, cool. Mine's have not, okay, guys? I'm gonna try my best not to get emotional because it's still an emotional process for me. But like the ancestors told me, they was like, there's gonna be times where we are the caterpillar, okay? You gotta go through the chrysalis. The chrysalis hurts. Ooh, I'm the same size on the inside. I mean, the shell is the same size, but I'm growing bigger on the inside. Oh, growing pains. Ugh. And then you're over it, right? You get your wings, you fly off. But what about when the snake sheds its skin? What about when the crab sheds its shell? It's different. I just went through a shedding, not a transformation. I didn't go through a chrysalis. I know what a chrysalis feels like, okay? Ooh, I'm about to get my wings. No. In the process of like the caterpillar becoming a butterfly, it's still the same caterpillar. It still got all its genetic material that it's taking with it. You know what I'm saying? It's just, it's evolving into something bigger and better than what it already is, but it has to take everything that it already is in order to become that. The snake though, the snake gotta get, it's ridding itself. It's getting rid of something. It's leaving it behind. It can no longer stay. It cannot come with thee, okay? And that's what I just went through, y'all. When I say, I didn't even like the sound of my own voice, okay? I didn't. I was looking at like some of my old videos and I was cringing because I didn't even like my fucking acrylics being that long and shit. I didn't like my choice of hairstyles. I didn't like the content I was making. I didn't like, it didn't feel authentic to me no more, and hence why it's been almost, 5 months since y'all seen me. I felt like the ancestors didn't give a fuck about none of that love shit. Why am I talking about that love shit? Like, what are we doing here? And where am I steering you guys? And heavy is the head that wears the crown, and everybody want to be a light worker. Everybody want to be a high priestess, but what does that responsibility look like? And bro, when I say I just shedded a huge layer to the point where I don't know this bitch yet. She painting her nails. I ain't painted my nails since freaking middle school. Excuse these because they peeled off. But like, I'm painting my nails. I've been getting acrylic since high school. Like, who are you, darling? Who are you? Like, what are you? What is she like? She been dressing real chill. She don't really want to do too much. You know what I'm saying? It's just, I want to hug you too, Queen Diamond, because I'm fighting tears right now, y'all, because I started this channel with her. But it's a huge part of her that the ancestors are saying that I can't take with me. And my abandonment issues kick in overdrive because I'm like, oh, no, I'm not letting this shit go. I got to figure out how I can fit it in wherever it can get in. And they like, no, you have to shed. And I'm not saying that there was anything wrong with her or like anything wrong with what I'm shedding about her. But it's just so much differences with this new version of Jazz that just don't coincide. And I'm here to let y'all know that it's okay to start over. Okay? It is okay to start over. No matter how many times you gotta start over, it's just okay. You have to convince yourself that it only takes you one time to succeed at something, but it might take you several times to fail prior to that succession. So I'm at this place where like going back to this blank canvas and getting back to being a novice and going back to point A again, like it's so uncomfortable. You know what I'm saying? Like, but it's necessary. And I've come to this realization that a huge part of what I've been healing lately is my divine masculine energy. Not realizing how many times this ambitious motherfucker on the inside of me refuses to give up. It didn't matter if it was personal training. I'ma do it. All right, this ain't working. I'ma go figure this out over here. Plan A, B. Plan A, 2. All right, this failed. I'ma go figure this out over here. Plan A, 3. All right, we got to fix this, tweak that, revamp this, refurbish that, plan A4. My divine masculine energy is butt hurt in the corner in fetal fucking position with tears in its eyes, just tired of fucking failing sometimes. And my divine feminine energy kicks into overdrive and has to nurture the fuck out of that part of my spirit because, and this is a reflection of the men in our world, guys. How many of them wake up every day, put an S on their chest, never let their ambitions get rocked out their system, and no matter what endeavors, no matter what they pursue, no matter what goals that they have in mind, they get faced with failure. Do you know how hard it is to get back up and dust yourself off and act like that shit ain't hurt? Do you know how hard it is to take it on the chin? especially when it's multiple times, but that's because we don't realize that it only takes one time to succeed. But they never told you how many times that it would take until you get to that part of that process. So a huge part of my divine masculine energy needed some extra TLC, because it was like, bro, I watched you start so much shit in the name of your dreams, okay? And not quit to this day. How the fuck do you still keep going? Who is holding you up? Who is helping you out? Like, who is, where do you get this strength from? And he told me, he was like, I do it for our inner child. I do it for our divine feminine. I do it for our internal spirit family, okay? A lot of y'all divine masculine energies, whether you are male or female, okay? We all have it. It's the butt hurt. And y'all wondering why, like, I don't know where I'm going. I don't know where I was going with that. But yeah, y'all been shedding. You feel that? You feel that, Q? They be hurt, but what type of strong motherfucker do it with tears in their eyes and just don't give up? It's like when it comes to the divine masculine, quitting is just not in their vocabulary, but they want to do it with all the wounds. Whether they still open or sewn together. And I'm just like, in the spirit realm, watching this nigga on the inside of me just, you know, bag over the shoulder, all beat up, all bruised up, just like, y'all coming? Come on, man. We still on the journey. And I'm just, I could cry. Because he's been leading this journey. Because out of all parts of my spirit, the divine masculine is the one that won't let any other part give up. They be like, you tired? Take a break. That's it, though. You tired? Take a break. That's it. So some of y'all might resonate with this shedding process of the journey, where it's just like, out with the old and for real, in with the new. It's certain parts of yourself that won't resonate with this new part of your journey. And that's okay. It's perfectly fine. Like, I don't know what type of content I want to make for y'all. I really don't. I don't. And I've been asking Spirit, like, what type of content does the Spirit family need from me? And they just always confirm it. They just need you. So, yeah, we might pull cards, but we might not. Because maybe that's the message, y'all. Maybe it's not in here. You know, maybe it is, though. And that's why, as y'all can see the title, I just put, I don't know yet. Because I don't know yet. I don't know yet. And that's okay. Like, I don't know yet. But we gonna find out. Once we hit play, I promise you, we gonna find out. But in the beginning, I might not know yet. I might not. And that's okay. But if I'm called to show up, I'm always show face. But it's been a lot of purging. It's been a whole lot of purging. And may I just rant? Because I don't got no safe space outside of y'all. Can I just rant real quick before we pull anything? Am I safe here? Can I just rant one time? Like, can I rant with y'all one time? Because, yes, okay. I just needed a few people to say yes before I just, you know, like, just start going in. All right, y'all already know, 'tis the season, okay? This is one of the most darkest, demonic, if you want to call it that, right? This is one of the most densest seasons of the year. We are surrounded by death by the winter months, okay? And I've never felt it like I felt it this year, though. Our cognitive dissonance is like the tension in a room that you can cut with a knife. I am so disappointed in my Black people. Why? Absolutely why is the majority of us still celebrating the massacre of the Native Indigenous Americans? Why? Why are we acting like our ignorance is blissful when we all know the truth? We are in the age of Aquarius. It is too much information available to us for us to only believe what they taught us in history, U.S. history, in our schools, in our public school systems. Why? Why are we still doing this? And why are we subconsciously telling our children that shit like this is okay? Why? Then you gonna turn your black ass around and go shop for Black Friday. Why? Why are we this? Like, why are we like this? They done fucked us over real, something real good, y'all. They done fucked our heads up something real good. That programming runs so deep, don't it? Why? Why are we like this? I'm so serious. This is the equivalent of, all right, I'm gonna give y'all an example. What if Australians, right? They continent all the way over there. What if Australians decided that on Juneteenth, sorry, let's just pick a random day, any day, they want to celebrate the transatlantic slave trade? Y'all, that's the equivalent of what we doing. What is wrong with us? How did we justify this all these years? How did the baby boomers, ain't nothing clicked and they, ain't nothing in nothing clicked and was like, whoa, wait a minute. And then, like I said, your black ass turn around and go shop on Black Friday. Who and what the fuck do you think was on sale way back then on Black Friday? Your black ass ancestors. Like, why? Why are we like this, y'all? Like, and we gonna keep perpetuating. We gonna keep celebrating they shit. We gonna keep spending our money on they days. We gonna keep, that's what we doing? Come on, y'all. Thanksgiving was the way that them pilgrims celebrated wiping out an entire village of people. Now, why do you think that they targeted, is it the Pequot Indians? Correct me if I'm wrong, drop it in the comments, y'all. But why do you think that they targeted them? Because they was the darker the berry, the sweeter the juice. That's why when they tell y'all Native Americans, the ones that y'all see today is not the ones that was on this island when they arrived. They was the darker the berry, the sweeter the juice. And they eradicated that whole entire tribe because while they were interbreeding the race of Native Americans to make them more lighter skin, they had to get rid of the blueprint. They had to get rid of the evidence. And the celebration occurred after they eradicated this group of people. Your ass, the same group of Americans that are celebrating the Thanksgiving are celebrating the massacre of their indigenous ancestors. What is wrong with us? When does it click? When does it? Tatiana, believe it or not, you say, and a good amount of us have Native bloodline. Like this or love this. If you are from the Americas, you have Native bloodline. Like this or love this. If you are from the Caribbeans, you have Native American bloodline. Them is our people. Like, they tried to separate us so much because they ultimately gave these Native Americans reparations, and they will be damned if they ever give our black asses any reparations for what was done to our ancestors, okay? That's where the separation occurred, but we are one in the same, y'all. We are one in the fucking same. Don't let them separate us. I personally believe that them Native Indigenous Americans was just one of the first tribes or groups of people to leave Africa before it was popping, before it was trending. They was the trailblazers. They was the ones that was like, all right, we're gonna go see what else is out here. Y'all catch us if you can. Meet us when you can. Catch up. That was dumb. The ones that heard the message and just took off. And they settled where they settled, which was all throughout the Caribbeans, which was all throughout South America, which was all throughout the Americas in general. So that separation happened when that whole little $5 Indian thing came into play where people could pay $5, which was a lot of money back then. And who had money? If we was all slaves, who the fuck had money back then? Massa. So you pay $5 to get put on that Native American list. And once your name was on there, everybody that you gave birth to was considered what? A Native Indigenous American. And got what? All of the reparations and the land and every benefit associated with being a Native Indigenous American. So they wiped out all the Native Indigenous Americans, gave y'all this opportunity to pay $5, get your name put on this list. So the same master that was killing the Native Indigenous Americans, majority of their bloodline is what we call today the Native Indigenous Americans. And that's where the separation has to occur, because they don't ever want you to consider or fathom the fact that you yourself are a Native Indigenous person. So I just say this to say, because y'all, a lot of y'all about to turn around and celebrate Christmas. Look, y'all, cognitive dissonance hurt, don't it? It do. You've been celebrating this shit all your life. Ain't nobody told you to question nothing. And now when the facts is put in front of your face, it stings, it burns, it hurts, y'all. It do. But are you going to keep perpetuating these negative programmings? The mind is a whole separate entity, y'all. Believe it if you want to or not. It is a whole separate entity. And your beliefs, they shape and they form your life. In your entire existence, what you put into this motherfucker will regulate your entire existence. And what we've been allowing society to pump into our brains, that is a telltale sign when we look at the state of our communities, how the beliefs of our oppressors have regulated our entire existence until the black community, not just the few billionaires we have now, but the entire community of a people is uplifted. That should be a telltale sign to the state of our minds. Because before they put our ass in them damn shackles and them damn, the gel polish is flying off. Like, I'm not using this top coat no more. Like, it's peeling. Before they put you in them cuffs, all right, they put this in a prison. And once this was in a prison, putting this on your flesh, that was the easy part. So we got to really, really pay attention to what we're celebrating. That energy that they're harvesting off of us during this death season. Come on now. Where's my high priestesses? Y'all know how this shit work. Look at this. Can y'all see? Let me show y'all something. Look at this. Black candle. Black candle. I don't do nothing to nobody. I stay to myself. I barely be outside. Black candle. Y'all, it's tis the season. That's what I'm trying to tell y'all. You can't help if you bump into it. You can't help if it's around you. They're harvesting. Oh, did I just zoom in? That was tight. That was tight. They're harvesting. And that's just what they do. And then y'all know come January, February, Grammys time, somebody gonna die. Pay attention to the cycles, y'all. And they use this gathering, they use this excitement, they use this celebratory energy to continue the harvesting process. So yeah, I think that's all the download. Stay protected. Y'all already know. Stay ready so you don't have to get ready. Don't wait for the shit to happen for you to go asking your ancestors for something. Just stay ready. Tell them if in the event. Let them know just in case. For future references. That's how you approach that. You know what I'm saying? Just stay ready. But you can't help it. You just can't help it, y'all. Let's tap in, soul family. I actually do feel like pulling cards. Because as of right now, we still ain't got no title. The title says, I don't know yet. So let's see. Giving you the best to me. Amazing. Amazing. Yes. Absolutely, y'all. Ancestors, speak to our hearts, speak to our souls. Thank you, God. Thank you, angels. Thank you, ancestors. Thank you, ascended masters. Mother God, Father God, I ask that you utilize me as a humble vessel. Fill me up with divine love. divine light, divine lessons, divine blessings, divine guidance, and divine intuition for myself and for my beautiful soul family. I ask that you fill us up until we overflow, mentally, spiritually, physically, and emotionally. I shade to the ancestors. I eat bobo to my lineage. I moon to the originals. I feel guided to say this prayer. Hold on, I hope it don't kick me out if I send it to the tablet. I'm gonna read this. Probably should have read the English version too, right? But this is a Creole. This is a prayer in Creole. So shout out to all of my Haitian subscribers. I was guided to make this at a time where I was going through a lot of spiritual warfare, and it works. So excuse my pronunciation. My ancestors truly appreciate my effort, and I hope that you appreciate my effort too. All right, guys, look, that Brooklyn baby making me nervous now because she Haitian and she about to hear all of the mispronunciations, but it's cool. You know, the ancestors, they vibe with it. Nevertheless, we got 101 people in the building. We only got 55 thumbs up. I humbly ask on your way in, please do not forget to like, share, subscribe, and comment if you find that my content resonates with your soul. I'll be right back. I want to get the English translation for y'all too because that's not fair, right? All right. We in there. All right, guys. Tout gloire mwen bay bon Dieu. Merci pou san ki nan ven mwen. Van nan pou mou mwen. Konsyans nan tèt mwen. E l'amou nan kem. Mwen rekonsan pou zansèst avèk loyo ki e dim reyousi tout potansyèl. Eskyuzèm pou sa mwen pa konnen. Tan pri e dim grandi nan espri. Kouvrim avèk fòsou, potejèm avèk grasou, vire dou lèm pou viktwa. Gide mach mwen lèn tout problem. Kontinye geri tout maladi. Dilivrem soti nan nepot obstak ki ap chache sispon destinasyon. Bom zam ke mwen bezwe pou komba tout emim yo. Ak kapasite pou poteje la pe mwen, nan mi tan an pil ere mwen te fe. Tan pri padonem paskyom se pitit ou. Kontinye jijem dapre pitiye nan kem. Mem jan mwen navige eksperyans mwen. Mersi pou l'amou, sante, family, avek la vi, ayi bobo. So guys, says all praises due to the Most High. Thank you for the blood in my veins, the air in my lungs, the consciousness in my mind, and the love in my heart. I'm grateful for you sharing my ancestors and Loa with me to help me be the best version of myself. Forgive me for what I do not know, and please allow me into your spirit to grow from your wisdom. Cover me in your strength and shield me in your grace. Turn my pain into purpose and guide my footsteps towards righteousness. May you continue to heal every sickness and deliver me from any obstacles that seek to stop my destiny. Give me the weapons I need to defeat my enemies and the discernment I need to protect my peace. In the midst of my many mistakes, forgive me, please, as I am your child. May you continue to judge me according to the purity of my heart as I navigate my human experience. Thank you for love, health, family, and life. So the Creole translation is going to be a little different from the English translation because a lot of these words is not translatable. But that is the gist of what I just said to my Haitian ancestors in Creole. I want to put that over the channel as well. And for whoever wants to receive it, put that in your heart and in your spirit if you're open to receiving it. So I believe we blessed our reading multiple times. This is just like an overly blessed. Yes, merci bon Dieu. I love y'all. All right, I wasn't even guided to start with that deck. Let me go with what they told me to do. I just realized what they was trying to do. This is an all African reading. They told me to grab the African Goddess Rising And then we have the Afro Goddess Oracle. And then I pulled this and blew some dust up off it, the African American Tarot. Ancestors, what's our overall message? Full moon in Gemini. I love you, that Brooklyn baby. Because y'all want to know something funny? You said like your ancestors told you, right? Y'all know Virgos get all this hype for giving good advice. Y'all know if y'all stop seeking it. Like, we don't take our own advice. It don't matter how good of advice that we have. We don't listen to our own advice. I'm eating pears and caramel and I'm drinking raspberry leaf tea. That's so weird, I know. But yeah, so if y'all stop asking Virgos for advice, we would never be able to pull it out. Like, we wouldn't even know that it's in here because we don't follow that shit. We don't know how to listen to ourselves, even though we give the best so-called advice. Like, Virgo's life will be in shambles and have every fucking body else shit together. It's the truth. Like, it's the truth. It's the truth. And then just be learning through the advice that we give everybody else when we're not hard-headed, when we're not stubborn. We'll finally take the advice, you know? I'm trying to tell you, I bet you your best friend will probably be going through shambles, K-Swin. But your life be impeccable, on point. She'll have you right. She'll have you right. And then her hermit ass won't let nobody in close enough to even check her or get her right. So shout out to the people that are close enough to a Virgo to check their ass and get them right. They don't trust no fucking body. They don't. Unless it's like another Virgo. I don't know. Why are we like this? You said Sagittarius too? I feel that. Ancestors, what's the overall message? Speak to our hearts, speak to our soul. Full moon in Gemini. I love y'all. See, that's such a misconception though, Brianna, because you said Venus and Virgo. I know what to tell you about love, but I don't got anyone. Y'all want to know what's crazy? I will probably only take relationship advice from single people. Because the dating pool has fucking piss in it. And if you're solid-minded enough to know how to be by yourself in this society of people just with fucked up ass attachment styles, just wanting to attach themselves to something, I might actually listen to what the fuck you got to say. Half of these married people ain't happy. And that's why the divorce rate is pumping, y'all. I'm trying to tell you, just because you in your house, enjoying your company, know how to be okay with the company that you keep by yourself, you not doing life wrong. Some of the motherfuckers that rushed into that marriage and rushed into that relationship, they the ones doing life wrong. They the ones that's not happy. Some of these wives, you want to talk about single mothers, right? And the epidemic of single mothers that raised us, the millennials, right? Some of these married women is single fucking mothers. They husbands don't even help them with the kids. Y'all, the whole divine balance of yin and yang is just fucked up. All right? It's just fucked up. So I'm just here to tell you, I will listen to a single bitch tell me some shit about my love life. I sure would. And I wouldn't look at her singleness as a disqualification factor for her to be able to school me on some shit. I wouldn't. Because I done seen 1, 2, 3, 4 too many unhappy girlfriends, unhappy fiancés, unhappy wives, unhappy baby mamas, too many unhappy titles. If I'm gonna be an unhappy bitch, let me be an unhappy lonely bitch. Let me blame myself for my unhappiness. Let me be the sole reason and purpose for this frown that's on my face. You ain't gonna be in my life and be the cause for this shit, or be in my life and not be able to fix this problem, because we clearly see it's a problem. A bitch ain't happy.
What are we doing? What are we doing? We're in a society where people, unfortunately, just want to be in something to say that they got it. I am guilty of that. I just left a relationship, guys, that I known my whole fucking 20s. And I had to sit down and ask myself, because I promise you, about 4 to 5 years ago, it clicked in me. We are not on the same page. We're growing apart. Something's got to give. And either he can change or I can change. And you want to know what I did? I started dimming my fucking light just to fit myself into that relationship again. And I had to ask myself a real long, hard question. Jazz, what are you still doing here when you know this ain't your place to be? This ain't the place for you. I didn't want to deal with what I had to tell my grandmama who loved the fuck out this nigga. I didn't want to deal with the embarrassment of all the time I invested in what my family would think. Come on now. I'm talking to a woman that needs to hear this. You know damn well you don't want to be in that situationship no more. You just don't want to deal with the aftermath that comes with it. Some of these people just want to be with somebody just to say they have somebody. I was one of them people. I was one of them people. Fulfilled or unfulfilled, it didn't matter. I learned how to maneuver in all of my unfulfillment. I learned how to dim my light, my wants, my needs in the midst of my unfulfillment. Because I didn't want to have that conversation with grandma. Because unfortunately, I love you to death. Your husband sitting at my altar, I love you to death too. This nigga right here, 36 kids, 2 before he married her, 4 by her. Okay, where we at? 7, 2, yeah, we at 6, 4 by her. 36 kids. So I didn't want to deal with that conversation of her level of programming from the baby boomers generation that didn't have the same opportunities as us to tell me to stay in the situation just because it ain't all the way broken. This ain't no judgment towards my grandmama. She lived in a different time than I did, but I didn't have to stay in some shit that was broken. I didn't have to stay in some shit that wasn't doing what it needed to do for me. Some of y'all need to hear that. It's better off that you deal with that aftermath that you're trying to avoid than to keep trying to save face in a situation that is not fulfilling you mentally, spiritually, and physically. Some of these niggas know how to fuck y'all real good, and that's about it. And now y'all be mind fucked for that physical flesh attachment. Ain't nothing invoking your spirit about this connection, and you are a spiritual high priestess or a hierophant, and you're wondering why you don't feel completely fulfilled. It's just because they know how to get your flesh real good, but they don't know how to get deep into your spirit. Maybe I'm talking to myself, or maybe I'm talking to one of y'all, but y'all deserve to have somebody penetrate the fuck out your spirit too. Y'all deserve to have somebody penetrate your mind as well. You don't deserve to settle. You don't deserve to compromise. You don't. And there is somebody for everybody. So some of y'all are holding on to somebody else's husband. Some of y'all niggas is holding on to somebody else's wife. we need to learn how to let people find their people. When it's unfulfilling, that's a sign. It's not a red flag. It's just a sign. Y'all ain't growing together, and that's okay. A card came out, y'all. Ooh, scarcity. Goddess Sukuyant, she came out to talk about scarcity. This is a whole mindset. This is a mentality. A lot of you guys, I mean, we was talking about relationships. A lot of you guys feel like the grass is not greener on the other side. A lot of y'all don't like this idea of starting over. A lot of you guys are just completely, you rather deal with the devils that you know versus the devils that you don't. That is a scarcity mentality. Some of y'all don't feel like going through the process of finding what it is that you're looking for. And it's not because of how tedious this process is. It's because of the lack mentality that what you're looking for is not out there. So you rather stay with the half-ass version of what you want versus the full-ass version that's out there. In order for you to even start the process of going out there, you got to believe that it exists. It always brings me back to that commercial. It's like a holiday commercial with the M&Ms when they be like, it does exist. They do exist. Like, that's the medicine for this scarcity mindset. It don't matter if it's a lover, a divine counterpart. It don't matter if it's a tax bracket that you're trying to reach. Damn it, it does exist. It do exist. It's motherfuckers out there in that tax bracket as we speak. It don't matter if it's a career, a job, a business opportunity. It does exist. It do exist. This is the medicine I hear, y'all. Because these words, they powerful. You got to convince yourself that something does exist in order for you to kick this lack mindset out. Then on top of it does exist, it do exist. God damn it, that's for me. It's got my name on it. I deserve that shit. I put in that work for it. You know what I'm saying? You got to feel worthy at the same damn time. Some of y'all be looking at these motherfuckers and they starstruck you. It's like, oh my God, this is what I pray for. This is what I asked for. Now you feel like God didn't sign, seal, and deliver that for you? The fuck what you think? You got to feel like you know it's yours too. This could be about any goddamn thing, all right? So apply it to anything in your life. This scarcity mentality cannot come with us whatsoever. It just can't. It ain't got no room. We got to shed that part of ourselves. Because it's almost like you downplaying yourself. That's what the scarcity-ness is. That's like you downplaying yourself. Let's get this out the book. Sukuyant. She is the shadow of scarcity from Trinidad, the temple of shadows, the element of air, beauty by day and a hag by night. The Sukuyant is an energy vampire, also known throughout the diaspora as Ohigu and Buhag. Whether energy or blood, for vampires there is never enough to go around. Her shadow guidance says you have so much more than you realize. You have access to unlimited joy, love, good times, pleasures, and prosperity. Be grateful for your riches. It says, stop going to the ocean asking for a thimble full of water. It doesn't feel like it when you're desperate, but scarcity and lack are an illusion. Prosperity is believing that there is an overflow, more than enough love, happiness, well-being, and money to go around. Vampires take from others because they don't have enough life force for themselves. That is scarcity consciousness. When you embody lack, you are always hungry, tired, and jealous. Make a gratitude list. What are you grateful for right now? Goddess declaration, my blessings always overflow. Yeah, some of y'all just be like, God, I just want a little bit of love. I just want a little bit of money. I just want a little bit of sex. I just want a little bit of wisdom. Like, why a little bit? Why just a little bit? I love this cup, y'all. It says, I do not wish women to have power over men, but over themselves. I love this cup. But why just a little bit? Like, why just a little bit? Who said that though? A little bit of sex. I think that was DC Young Fly. That was so funny. He was just like, no, I think it was E-Man Hudson. He was like, I just want a little bit of sex. Why just a little bit? Oh, I just pulled these. Why just a little bit? Why y'all ask for a lot? I'm talking to somebody. This transpires in every aspect of your life. You get to the job interview. You don't even negotiate your salary. You get in a relationship. You take the bare minimum. Why just a little bit? Why is such a small portion enough for you? Who taught you to ask for the bare minimum? This is somebody too. Y'all don't know how to even ask y'all man for money. Not even just money, resources, right? Resource, whatever. Where does that stem from though? Because that motherfucker asks you for some ass whenever he can, every chance he get. That motherfucker asks you for some nurturing. Yeah, he'll ask you for a home-cooked meal. He'll form his lips to ask you for any goddamn thing that he can. But when it comes to you asking for things that you genuinely want, you struggle. You do. You struggle here. Somebody don't know how to receive. And this stems from a scarcity mindset. And if you don't know how to receive, then you are also struggling with how to sit in your feminine energy as a result. I say it is always wise to ask a man for anything. It don't have to be money. All right, he only make 40-50K a year. Don't ask his ass for no money. He probably need it for his bills. But ask him for a ride. Ask him for a car wash. Ask him to come around the house and put some shit up. Ask him to come build a table. Men love to be needed. When you are not in that feminine part of your energy and operating in the masculine opposite of it, sometimes men don't feel needed. And they thrive in their masculine energy whenever they have an opportunity to be or to feel needed by their loved ones. Ask that nigga for some shit. Ask him. Because personally, I don't even know a man like me unless he's spending money on me. You could be like, you are so beautiful. He just think I'm cute. It's a bunch of cute bitches out here. You could be calling me every goddamn thing. He think I got good conversation. I'm an intellectualist. Fuck you mean. You could be texting me all the time. He thinks I'm funny. He like the memes and shit I be sending him. We'll be good friends. All right? I don't even know a nigga like me until you spend some coins. Because guess what men value? They value their status. Their status is linked to their money. And if a man don't spend what he values on you or use what he values on you, which is linked to his resources, the more he invests, the least likely it is for him to, because when he got to leave all of what he invested as well. So yeah, some of y'all need to feel comfortable asking men for more out of y'all situations and y'all dynamics, because something programmed you that it would be a turnoff, and it's actually the complete opposite. And I will lead by saying, if he fuck with you, if he like you, a lot of these men will fuck on you and they don't fuck with you. And that confuses the fuck out of an emotional feminine energy, because to us, we won't fuck on you if we don't fuck with you 9 times out of 10. Some of y'all savages, but 9 times out of 10. We won't really fuck on you unless we fuck with you. But some of these men will fuck on you without fucking with you. So just make sure he like you. Make sure he fuck with you. And that is not like a thumbs down. That's going to be a thumbs up in your situation. Because if you make that man feel needed, that makes that man feel masculine. Hands down. We got 121 people in the building. We only got 88 thumbs up. If y'all really miss me like I missed y'all, I humbly ask when y'all weigh in. Please do not forget to like, share, subscribe, and comment if you find that my content resonates with your spirit. All right, y'all. Let's get another card. Ancestor, speak to our hearts, speak to our souls. I actually want to build on this scarcity if we can. If you could tie this in. Scarcity about what? This is interesting. There's enough knowledge to go around. Oh, Brianna, you felt that too? Truth? Okay, I see truth in this as well. Yeah, so I think what they're trying to say, sometimes y'all know how y'all come into the spiritual community and it feel like on some channels it's like this spiritual dick swinging contest. Like, I ain't gonna hold you. It's like my knowledge, my ancestors, my spiritual path, my journey, my... And it's just like, well, bitch, if you're not gonna share with me, what the fuck am I watching for? Like, if it's not ours, then how do we commune with this? How do we commune over this? How do we create a community? But yeah, sometimes it do feel like that. It feels like a spiritual dick swinging contest. Like, you don't know as much as me. And it creates this like false ass race to the knowledge or to the information or something. And it's just like, bitch, you're running and I am literally slow walking. Like, this is not, we're not, you know, I feel the need to say, like, this is in our Akashic records. That's what the librarian is showing me. Like, this is not, bitch, just because you pulled out the book on the left and I pulled out the book on the right, we still in the Akashic records. Like, can you give me the synopsis from your book on the left while I give you the synopsis from my book on the right? And can we both just acknowledge that we both in the same, we in the battlefield together? Like, there's this lack of camaraderie and sisterhood and brotherhood within the spiritual community. And I think that it stagnates a lot of the growth that we're supposed to be moving towards, because a lot of this is about to be collaborative. A lot of us got to put the egos to the side and learn how to work with a motherfucker. We got to learn how to share what we have with one another and not hope that the hoarding and the gatekeeping that we're doing makes us better than somebody else. And I was told at about 3-4 years ago, you will never be free until you help free somebody else. You won't. That knowledge will haunt you until you give it to somebody else that's stuck in that same place that you were in when you had to find it. But maybe they don't have the same key to the same door to get out that situation, because you, my friend, are their key while they're in the midst of it. That's why it's each one, reach one, each one, teach one. You know what I'm saying? Because you, my friend, might be the key for me in the midst of my darkness to get the fuck up out of it. And a lot of people will rather sit there and watch you in it. You want to know why? Because they either profit from it. You got the people who everything is for a profit. Everything got a dollar sign attached to it. A bitch can't even give you a 30-minute consultation without taxing that ass. Like, this is where the spiritual community has gotten to, where it's like, we act like there's this scarcity for knowledge. Not we, some people. Some people act like there's this scarcity for knowledge when I believe that the divine spirit of life is trying to get the collective to a place where we all in this motherfucking Akashic records. You pulling this book, I'm pulling that book, you pulling this book, and then we just sharing everything. Because then nobody's stuck out here. Nobody is codependent on the next priestess and on the next hierophant who got this amount of knowledge versus this amount. No. We all getting each other together. We all get each other to a place of we got it from here. We could take it from here. If you've been my client since I started, I'm doing something wrong, because the student is only as good as the fucking teacher. Period. I'm not explaining this shit correctly. I'm not reading these cards right. If I didn't put you on your path by now, I'm profiting off of your ignorance. And that's what some people in our community want. They want to have sheep. They want to have their flock. Whereas some of us just want us to all be solid and stand solid together. You know what I'm saying? Okay, it took us a long time to get that point home. But let's get this out the book real quick. I'm dusty. I'm a little rusty. I ain't pulled the cards out in a second. If it's taking me a little longer to drive it home, y'all, just bear with me. Because that was like 5 unnecessary minutes just to get to that one point. All right, the librarian. Yes. Where is the librarian? page 31.
That's the way that it goes. It's alright.
Alright, y'all. Tucked away within the library of life, we find the librarian tending to all the secrets of existence. If you have a question or obstacle, she has an answer or path through. Often soft-spoken, this wise character has wisdom one must often lean in to hear. So can you silence yourself and listen for an answer? Valuable information resided behind the lips of this person. And if applied correctly, the sun shall shine to illuminate your path forward. But for now, stop and listen. In regards to another platonic person, this person is full of knowledge and wisdom. Absorb all you can from them as you enter the library of life. In regards to a romantic relationship, this person is or is becoming an open book to you as they are now ready to share their innermost thoughts and dreams. So sit down and get ready for a good book. In regards to yourself, a good study session may be what you need. There is knowledge to be had and answers to uncover. Hit the books. I need a math tutor. I will give you readings, okay? I will pay you if you don't want that payment in the form of readings. I will pay you, but I need a math tutor. If you got the time and you are one of those people that math just comes easy to you, help me. Please, because it's a struggle. All right, y'all. So the librarian, I feel like it's a bunch of Akashic Records scavengers right now. Like, we're all going through these fucking shelves looking for this specific book, but what the fuck are we looking for? Like, we all like, you seen it? Nah. All right, go look over there. All right, and then we just like all. It's like we're looking for something specific. They got us on some mission. It's a collective mission. We are astral traveling, okay? So whenever we're all asleep, we are all linking up in this fucking library of Akashic Records. And we just like, did you find it? What are we looking for? Calculus, statistics. Please help me. If y'all can. Hey, Nima, that just made me think. And what are we tossing to this side in this desperate search? Probably a bunch of valuable information while we just so desperately looking for this one thing. I don't know. I'm stuck on this. Like, why is everybody in the Akashic Records right now? Math is one of the, I just feel like a complete dummy in this subject. Like, everything else, I'm good. I'll figure it out. Math puts me at a complete block. Like, I'm stuck in my tracks. And I'm just like, all right, y'all. Scarcity. Ancestors, what is this scarcity mentality? What is this about? What is this towards? The Five of Pentacles. I swear it's enough for everybody to eat. This money shit is fake, y'all. That dollar, it ain't backed by shit. And the moment that you realize that that US dollar ain't backed by no gold, that British pound ain't backed by no gold, it holds no value. Our currency is fucking digital now. You will start to reshape and reformulate your relationship with money. You will realize how much of a vibration that it is. And what do we know about vibrations? They here, but they not visible. So y'all be looking in y'all bank accounts. Y'all be looking in y'all pockets. Y'all be looking in y'all wallets and y'all purses for something that's here but not visible. It's not supposed to be seen. That is an illusion. The one that you touch, the quarter you touch, the dollar you touch, the penny you touch, the British pounds that you touch. It's an illusion. Some of y'all with the Five of Pentacles energy, y'all be feeling left out in the cold. Y'all be feeling like y'all can't, you know, take them trips that you want to take, live that lifestyle that you want to live. But the reality of it is you're looking at your financial situation solely according to what's in your bank account, like I said, and not necessarily according to what you are currently tethered to that is here but not visible. You have to reconnect your cord to the money vibration once you get this idea that that shit that they show you is not real. It's fake. You want abundance before you want money. I swear, like, the money vibration is the abundance vibration, baby. You want abundance before you want money. Because even if I'm on this money vibration, I might get a dollar a day. That shit still ain't gonna add up. But if I'm attached to the abundance vibration and then abundance throw me on that money vibration, I might get 100,000 come in at one time. Because you see what I'm saying? Look at these vibrations. It's something that's here. It's just not visible. Some of you guys been struggling with finances. Some of you guys been struggling with trying to reach a certain level of capital or a certain level of savings in your account. And I think that you need to realize, you have to magnetize it to you. You do. And it sounds so crazy, right? But you have to magnetize it to you. You got to tell the universe what you want to spend it on, what you want to invest it in. You have to tell the universe, you know what I'm saying? You have to begin to embody that bitch that's spending it before it gets spent. So I do feel like the scarcity mindset stems from like a poverty consciousness as well. Some of you guys, you can't manifest what you've never seen. Some of us is coming out of straight poverty and straight struggle, you know, backgrounds, and trying to call in all of this ancestral abundance. And you go cutting through layers of lack mentality and poverty consciousness and scarcity. You cutting through layers because you can't manifest what you've never seen. You have to create this vision. And this is where being childlike and having a child's mind is so beneficial in our adulthood. Because how else do you imagine some shit? If that part of your soul is dark and damaged, how else do you manifest some shit? How else do you visualize some shit that you've never witnessed, that you've never had? And we all know how much representation matters. Half of us is trying to call ourselves beautiful, believe it, feel it, see it, but come on the television and you don't see anybody that looks like you. Half of us is trying to manifest ancestral abundance, trying to believe it, feel it, see it, but then you look at your family and you're probably the first college graduate, all right? So it is not your fault for feeling like you left out in the cold and feeling left out and feeling overlooked. It's not your fault, but it is your fault if you choose to not do something about it. And today, what you can choose to do about it is retether yourself, record yourself to the abundance and the money vibration. Don't look at what's in your pocketbook. Don't look at what's in your bank account today. Don't look at that. You need to look at, how did we get here? Shit, I ain't had no relationship with money all along. Let me go recultivate my relationship with money so the next time that it comes, check for me and see for me, I know what to do with it. I know how to manifest more of it. And y'all got to understand that dollar ain't shit. It ain't backed by no natural resource. It's just a piece of paper. Same thing goes for the British pound. And that's why they killed Gaddafi's ass, because Gaddafi knew that all the natural resources come from the continent of Africa. And he wanted to build the World African Bank, where they can back each individual dollar by the gold that's underneath the ground. And that would have put the U.S. currency, that would have put the British pound, that would have put everything beneath that currency. And ultimately, that would have put Africa on top of everybody else. You think these white motherfuckers would allow some shit like that to happen? I think not. So here we are, spending fake valuable money and allowing that to determine our status in society. Whether you middle class, high class, low class, when the shit is fake. Let's not talk about bricks though. That's a whole nother... It's like I'm happy with the trajectory, but that is a whole nother. I don't know what I'm trying to say, but it's just a whole nother. It's a whole nother thing to unpack within itself. I don't trust Russia. Okay? Putin is not this big bad guy that everybody tries to make him to be, but Putin is for self. All right. And the amount of the amount of involvement that I've seen him have in Haiti underhandedly, it bothers me, because Putin is for self. Anything for Russia. And that means stepping on the backs of anybody else, all right, too, in the process. So, yeah. I'm sorry. When it's so much change and evolution and revolution happening in Haiti right now, I can't really give a fuck about anybody or anything else that's happening in the world. I just can't. People are worried about the wrong type of wars right now. When they own fucking people been at war and struggling and all of a sudden they put some shit in your face and now it's just mainstream media. Like, no. Haiti been fighting the DR. How many of y'all knew that? Haiti's been building this canal, trying to just get running water for their irrigation systems, and they have to go through hell and high waters just to get this shit done. How many of y'all have sent money to Haiti? How many of y'all have fought for Haiti? That's y'all people too, right? What about the Congo? What about the don't nobody give a fuck? Don't nobody care? So we just gonna talk about the wrong shit, right? Not me. I can't, y'all. I can't. Sometimes it be feeling like selling your soul. It do. It be feeling like selling your soul. Talking about the propaganda. Like, clarify this librarian. What are we looking for? Because I swear, everybody is in this Akashic Records looking for something. The Five of Wands. We all like, why are we so conflicted? Why are we so internally conflicted? That's what we searching for, the answer? Why are we so conflicted? Oh, you know what? We was just talking about war. I think, like, we're trying to... Thank you for pointing that out, K-Swin. We do got 2-5. There's a lot of change happening. Now, what I was channeling just now is, like... Some of us is looking at the ancient texts, because a lot of these prophecies is prophesizing. A lot of the Book of Revelations, to me personally, has been happening, especially when you think about, like, the Euphrates River, Israel, the chosen people awakening, blah, blah, blah. I think we're comparing and contrasting. Like, this is what was prophesized. This is modern day what's happening. Like, we're at this place where it's just kind of like the math is mathing. We kind of see where the trajectory of our world is going. And I think we are currently living in apocalyptic times. It's just not this apocalypse that maybe as you were reading the text that you assumed it to be. But if you are surviving, you're thriving right now. Some people can't even survive the dense, dark energy that comes with this apocalyptic time. Those are the people who are opting out of the experience, whether that be through trigger words, suicides, or you can see some people's mental health deteriorating. And I think that is a telltale sign that the energy surrounding us is giving apocalyptic. A lot of us have been really looking into all of the internal and external conflicts that are happening around us and making it make sense in our own unique ways. So it's definitely giving prophesized. So look into some of those prophecies and see where we might be in the midst or in the middle of some of this shit. I don't have no deck to do a closing message, so give me 1 second. Let me see. Sorry, y'all. I'm rusty. All my cards are still packed up in boxes. By the way, I moved. New house. Who this? So, excuse me for having to get up and grab everything today. I just felt guided to come on and spend some time with y'all. I don't know what we talked about today, y'all. But I'll watch it back. Ancestors, close us out. Full moon in Gemini. Speak to our hearts. Speak to our souls. Closing message. Thank you, guys. I love this house. My office is going to be set up in the basement. A bitch got a basement. Like, what? Okay, let me stop. I just fangirled over my house for no fucking reason. Been here for like 2 months now. Uncalled for. But yeah, the office is going to be set up in the basement. And I just need, I'm waiting for the semester to end, which is going to be December 18th. Yeah. And then I'm going to take that time to get all set up. Like, I bought all my little decor, my decorations, my little vinyl wall stickers, and my pictures and stuff. So, I'm going to get it right. Y'all going to see the little setup very soon. But y'all know if all else fails, I take it right to the dining room table. And we're going to get our reading in regardless. Closing message. Listen to advice. This is funny because I was just talking about how Virgos don't listen to none of their advice. It says guidance is needed to cross the ocean of life. Where your good friends at? You know, like some of y'all have some really, really good friends that don't steer you in the wrong direction. Those are the people that I feel like spirit is encouraging you to listen to. Some of you guys don't know it all. That's okay. Some of you guys don't have all the answers. That's cool. Some of you guys don't have it all figured out. You ain't supposed to, okay? And it's okay to go to those trustworthy people and ask them, like, how you feel about this? Let me run this across you one time. Let me get your mindset or your perspective about this situation. I think some of y'all need that feedback. Like, you need to bounce what you think and you feel off of another trustworthy individual that... you know, whatever they add is going to be valuable. Whatever they add to your perspective is going to be valuable. And I might be talking to a Virgo here, because it's really hard for us to trust people with our truth or our secrets or whatever. And then if we get to that place, then it's hard for us to trust that whatever you're advising me is also worth taking heed to. So if you got that person, hold on to them and go pay them a visit one time, because I think that there's a situation in your life that it's hard for you to get a bird's eye view on. It's hard for you to take yourself out the situation and look at it from an outsider's perspective looking in. You are too consumed and caught up in the situation. That's why whatever you're advising yourself might not be the best advice. It's because you don't know how to step out of it, look at it, assess it, and then speak to it from there. Some of y'all is like, I just heard knee deep, like into something. I don't know. Let's get this out the book. All right. It says guidance is needed to cross the ocean of life. There is a quote here from Attar. Guidance is necessary to find your path. Don't enter the ocean blinded by pride. A guide is a shelter in your search. The road is long and you are blind. Your guide keeps watch over the way. An important aspect of Sufi wisdom is following the guidance of a master or peer. A Sufi wayfarer cannot make a journey without the guidance of the peer, who points the way towards certain paths that he or his predecessors have traveled. Attar is guiding you here to listen to the advice of those who come from the heart. A person who is connected with the heart is totally free and truly wants to share that freedom with the whole world. Sufi wisdom is with you, tingling in your heart and singing in the cells of your being. Divine guidance is coming your way to remove the uncertainty about an issue in your life. Soon, clouds of uncertainty will lift, and love will guide you to meet the secrets within you. Even if up to now you have handled just about every facet of your life, you are currently facing a challenge that requires help from a wiser and more experienced source. Beloved soul, your confusion over this matter is not caused by any negative reason, but rather by your lack of experience in dealing with such issues. The guidance that you will receive is going to bring you fulfillment, because you are now forced to grow, to gain new insight, and to further develop your character. Follow that sacred offering and know that all is indeed for your benefit. The mantra: I commit to asking for advice in matters in which I lack experience. I will seek the advice of those who come from the heart. So as long as they come from the heart, y'all ain't got nothing to worry about. And I think that coming from the heart is something that you will be able to feel. You will be able to discern. You will be able to know if somebody is coming from that heartfelt space when you ask them for their opinion or their advice about something. I don't got nothing else to talk about, y'all. Happy Saturn's Day. My dog's looking at me like, so you just not gonna walk us? Y'all are so welcome. I love y'all. I just love how majority of the names that I see all the time . Why you call me Ashley? You must know that's what my mama was going to name me, Queen Diamond. That just threw me off. I said, thank you, Jazz, a.k.a. Ashley. I'm like, you said I was giving Ashley But yeah, I forgot what I was just about to say. Oh, half of the names that I be seeing pop up here, A1 Day Ones. Y'all been here since the beginning, most of y'all. So I just want to take this time to say that this channel was built not just for you guys, but with you guys, and I'm going to continue to do everything that I can to grow this tribe and to grow this community and to grow this family. And I love y'all so much, and I'm grateful and appreciative of all the love that y'all send me. It is truly felt. Truly felt. I'd be sitting there just laying down and I get a random comment, and it's just like, y'all be knowing when to like spam me with the love too, because it is truly felt. And I appreciate this love, y'all, so much. When I say I just went through a period where I was like, I don't even like the sound of my voice. I don't like the content that I'm making. I don't like the way I look on camera. I don't know what I was going through, but I'm going through it. Okay, I'm still in the midst of it, and I'm just trying to show up for you guys as is. If this is not the energy from Jazz that you used to, bear with me. Bear with me. That's all I ask is for grace and patience, the same way I extend grace and patience to you guys. So until next time, Soul Family, hopefully it's not too long from now. I don't want to make no promises. I don't know. Like the title say, I don't know yet. I'm going to go change the title now. I think I know what we was talking about a little bit. Love, peace, light, and darkness.